Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play The Witcher 3. And in the last session, we finally made it here to the Crookback Bog. We had a few quests here for some time now. And we completed a couple of them. We helped the Peller's... We found the Peller's father's body, burnt it. We just have to go and tell the Peller that we've done the deed. And then we managed to, we managed to kill Swamp Thing. And before we continue any further, I'm going to conduct some readings. Because I haven't done that for some time. After I've just got rid of these. Probably put some of these away in my stash now, but anyway, they don't weigh anything, do they? Oh, they weigh very little. So, Elven Sages is the next book that I haven't read. Many think Ain Severn, meaning sage, is simply the elder speech term for sorcerer. Yet to equate a sage with a common practitioner of magic is akin to considering a newly drafted private hay sticking out of his breeches, a witcher's equal, simply because both wield swords. A sage wields magic, true, and does so with greater skill than even the most accomplished of human mages. The great renown and regard in which they are held, however, comes not from this skill, but from the other, truly rare abilities they possess. Nothing is secret for an elven mage. They see both past and future as easily as the present. They have mastery over all the arcana of magic as well as every domain of scholarship. They are the only ones who understand the nature and operation of the so-called Elder Blood and the gene of Lara Duren, and they guard this knowledge jealously. How numerous are the Elven Sages? In all my life I have met only one, Ida Emin of the Blue Mountains. She might possibly be the last representative of this mysterious caste. It is true I have encountered mention of a male elf who might also belong to it, but as of this writing, I have been unable to confirm this. Perhaps this is the elf that we are in pursuit of. From our trek into that dungeon, that cave with the late Kira Metz. I think we got that book from said dungeon, actually, so it's about time we actually got round to reading it. And the Bear Legend. The Berserkers do not constitute a separate clan in terms of blood or lineage. They are instead a family forged by warriors who have heard the call of the bear and answered it by abandoning their loved ones and joining the community of mountain dwellers. Not every man who seeks to join it is accepted into the Brotherhood. The candidates must first pass difficult trials, which usually end in their death. The last trial is the hardest. It is called the Trial of the Bear's Triumph. But few outside the Brotherhood ever have witnessed it, and none know what those who undergo it must endure. Quite curiously, the inhabitants of Skellige themselves know very little about the Berserkers, or Vildkarls, as they call them. They do not like to talk about these man-bears, not with outsiders, and not even amongst themselves. So it's a form of bear. Oh, it's a cursed one. Berserkers. We've also got Ulfadine. So this Skellige place sounds like a right hoot, littered with monstrosities, cursed beasts. Skellige legends speak of men known as berserkers who transform into bears when overwhelmed by battle rage. In doing so, they lose all self-awareness and are driven by a bloodlust which they must satiate in order to return to human form. Few believe these blood-curdling tales, however, not even in Skellige, where the inhabitants usually treat even the least probable legends with the utmost gravity. This indicates either that berserkers are in fact mere figments of Mead-sodden imaginations, or else they have learned to hide their abilities from the rest of the islanders. The Skald's ballads indicate a berserker transformed in the heat of battle cannot be distinguished from a true-born bear. Only minute anatomical details, such as the shape of their tongues and teeth, reveal their secret. Descriptions of their fighting prowess paint them as invulnerable to pain and able to heal any wound received almost at once. If these men-turned bears truly do exist, one can suppose that, like werewolves and lycanthropes, they are particularly vulnerable to oils that harm cursed creatures. But if we are to give credence to ancient songs about these creatures' deeds, about the mass murders and massacres they have committed, we can only hope that no witcher will have to test this hypothesis. I bet we do. Anyway, reading done. So at the end of the last session, I did say that we were going to head out to the Soothsayer, but I thought, you know what, in the past couple of sessions we've played a bit of Gwent. I'm sure you're itching to see something else, so I'm going to leave the Soothsayer for a little while and instead get my feet back on the right path. The path of the main quest line, because we're level 12 and the main quest lines are level 6, so we're going a bit ahead of where we should be in terms of the main quest, really. So the next part of the main quest is Ladies of the Wood, and we have to use our Witcher senses to find the shrine that marks the start of the Trail of Treats, so that we can find those dastardly crones. Well, that is exactly what we are going to do. We also got a decoction out of that book as well. It's amazing what you find stuffed into dusty tomes, isn't it? Find the crones of the Crookback Bog. I almost feel like breaking into song. You could make a musical out of it. A West End musical about the crones of the Crookback Bog and how they were so difficult to find. Unless, of course, you had Witcher senses, and then you were saved. Drowners. Okay. I know how to deal with you beasties, and it involves necrophage oil, a witcher's silver sword, and some igni. Oh yeah, and let's not forget a bit of quen as well. Come here. Let's play. Is this new battle music? It is! Cut him in half. Okay, that's satiated my pang for violence. Now back to the Trail of Treats. Starting here. The hell is this thing? Oh, we've got sweeties. A ticket he doesn't like sweets. Yep, we got a Trail of Treats here. Hansel and Gretel springs to mind. Oh, treats hanging from trees. I mean, this is a kid's heaven, isn't it? Treats hanging from every bloody branch littered across the floor. Although it's probably well past the 5-second rule. Shouldn't really eat them. The ones on the trees are fine, though. Eat them until your heart's content. Oh, if you go down to the woods today, you're sure of a tasty treat. This is quite a picturesque path. I could run, but I'm just soaking up this surreal atmosphere, really. Walking through a swamp with these lovely flowers dotting all along the path and sweets hanging from branches. It's not something you see every day, is it? Ah, we're going to this. I was a little bit intrigued as to what this was, so I think we're going to find out. Which pleases me. And it's 1 a.m, the perfect time to find some witches, eh? In the dead of night, early hours of the morning, when it's dark. Scary. So it's led us to this village. Just keep following the trail.
Doug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat.
Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty, stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said how tasty, best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup.
Now we'll light a fire, gonna roast him up. 1, 2, 3, the one to fetch the kindlings, thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you. Go away.
How rude!
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone. We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
Cheeky. Should give him a slap. Witches slap gobby children. Didn't know that.
I'm looking for the witches of Crookback Bog.
You looks like a witch yourself. The witches of the bog. We can't go in the bog. Gran don't let us.
When my brother Zemek went missing, Gran said it was because he went in the woods and got lost. Gran cried an awful lot after that.
You could still come back.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here. What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassies got tits.
They do.
Oh my god.
Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, hide them lassies in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads. That's what he said.
Oh dear. They seem a bit forward for their age.
Anyone else here, besides you?
Meaning who?
Someone who might have seen the woman.
Like the six-eyed tree?
Tree slapped all year. But there is Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids, they're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
Questions, questions, questions. She's a bit uppity.
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen him in the woods? No one has.
Who's Johnny?
Johnny ate a cat. Come the morn, some furry shat.
Watch your language. They tells tales and tales, naught but tales.
They've got foul mouths, these kids, Gran. You've got to show up some discipline, I'm telling you. My goodness me.
Are you one of the witches of the swamp? I hear Crookback Bog.
Witch? Me? Nay, I've no broom nor owl and not one wart on me nose. Got a pretty nose, see?
Gran's got a lovely beak.
Oh, you darling girl. Oh, kids are so sweet.
You've got a lovely beak. Oh, dear.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm.
A bit of help, please. A young, ashen-haired woman. Just need to know if you've seen her.
What are you looking at, children? Wash your hands, we'll go catch crickets.
Won't learn anything from you.
Aye, because I don't know nothing.
That Johnny knows. He knows a lot. When I ask him something, he says, wait, I'll scratch my arse and tell you.
Ugly word. What you saying? To the hut. You'll stand in the corner. I'll make sure you do. You, be gone. Be gone!
What a strange group of people. Go to the hut and talk to the boy. Will do. So we got Gran here. Yes. Strange woman. Let's go see if we can find this boy then. Coerce some further information out of him. The only lead we've got is this Johnny fella. I think the Gran's gonna let us in. Is she in here as well? She told us to go away and we just go and waltz on in. Sorry, Gran, but I'm persistent. Child, talk.
Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And stranger still, kids.
Just tell me where I can find Johnny.
Johnny's made up.
Be gone. Be gone!
Find a way to lure Gran away from the hut. Oh, this is gonna be fun. Make one of the kids cry. Then she'll come out running, okay? Ask them all to hide, maybe. Then she'll go looking for him.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny. He must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods. And then he's got to have a time out.
And he eats snails. Yuck.
Ugh, snails? Good grief. Even when doused in garlic butter, they're hideous.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right, but you gotta do something for us too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Hide and seek? Is there anything like money? Do you just want some money? I'll give you some money, it's easier.
Is there something else you need or want?
Mm. I want something sweet.
And me too!
Oh, fruits.
Give us a treat and we'll help you.
Here's some treats.
I've got some treats.
Yum!
Never eaten nothing like this before in my life!
Now?
Gran! Gran! Bumblebee bit Yagner in the arse! Gran! Come!
In the arse. Nice work, kids. I take it all back about you.
Don't be afraid.
Horrors.
Don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Where are you and your friend's parents?
Dad, some starved. Others were killed. Like mine. One day, I went out at dawn to look for berries in the woods. Still some around back then. When I was coming home, I heard the yells, then laughing, went up and hid in the bushes near the woods. My mum yelled, and the soldiers laughed, laid my paw down by the barn door, his head clean off, and then my mum...
It's all right. That's enough.
Yeah, good job, Geralt. Upset the poor child. Asking him to relive his horrors.
I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Cause he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy, cause Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There's a little meadow on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around. You'll see him.
Thank you.
Thank you, child. You should give him some treats now as well. You have the other one's treats. Can we give him treats?
Wonder where he's from.
Oh. Made him cry and we didn't even give him treats. How awful. Johnny, wherefore art thou, Johnny? In a meadow. The edge of the swamp.
Who said arse, eh? Ugly word, ugly. Don't cry, Yagner.
Yagner's a stupid pig.
Name calling's not allowed. Shouldn't say that. Apologise.
Arse.
I'll stand here till you apologise. to me.
They're doing a great job of distracting her, aren't they?
Apologies mean treats to please a belly needing to be put at ease.
Nope. Slip away unseen. Good job, kids. Treats well spent, I'd say. Alright. Come here, drowners! And the water hag as well. Oh my god! She's hulking up! The hell is- Half of it here. I'm not in combat here. Face the bloody thing, will ya? What the hell's happening? Ah.
If Johnny's real, he must leave prints.
Any footprints? Any prints? Oh, wait a minute.
Small footprint. Johnny's been through here.
Follow the prints. See where they lead. To Johnny's lair, probably. Rely on drowners to gate crash the party, can't you? Hey, here I am trying to just follow some footprints, have a peaceful walk in the swamp, getting my bloody feet wet, as if it's not traumatizing enough. Then those things are going to rise from the ground and harass me. Where the hell's he gone? Ah! Bingo!
Tracks lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.